नियतिकृतनियमरहितां क्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आददुति भारती क्रेर्जयति. वि लुक्ड् एट् द डेफिनेशन् आफ् अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसा. अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसा या सा एव प्रस्तुत आश्रया. प्रस्तुत आश्रया अप्रस्तुतस्य प्रशंसा यत्र वर्तते. अप्राकरणिकस्य अभिधानेन अप्राकरणिकः नान् काण्टेक्स्ट् द if the description of something which is not the context, which is not the prakritam, sandarbhaha yatra nasti, sandarbhatvam yatra nasti, tatra aprakaranikasya arthasya abhidanena, abhidanam ityukte vachyarthe prayujyamanam. So there is a varnana of the aprastutam or the aprakaranikam, that which is not the context. So prakaranikasya, what happens to the context, what is the relevant idea, that relevant idea akshepaha. प्राकरणिकस्य प्रस्तुतस्य आक्षेपः प्रतीयमानः. सो द रेलेवेण्ट् वन् विल् बि नोन् फ्रम् द डिस्क्रिप्शन् आफ् दि नान् रेलेवेण्ट् विच् इस् अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसा. देर् आर् फैव् टैप्स् आफ् इट्. विदिन् द फिफ्त् टैप् यु हेव् त्री फोर् फैव् वेरैटीस्. देर् आर् अ फ्यू मोर् देट् हि एड्स्. सो फस्ट् इस् कार्ये प्रस्तुते सति कारणस्य अप्रस्तुतस्य वचः वर्णनम्. इन् द कारिका इफ् यु सी कार्ये निमित्ते सामान्ये विशेषे प्रस्तुते सति तद् अन्यस्य वचः. देन् तुल्ये प्रस्तुते सति तुल्यस्य च वचः इति पञ्चदा. तद् अन्यस्य इत्युक्ते कारणादेः. कार्ये प्रस्तुते सति कारणस्य अप्रस्तुतस्य वर्णनं. निमित्ते विच् मीन्स् कारणं. कारणे प्रस्तुते सति कार्यस्य अप्रस्तुतस्य वर्णनं. सो सामान्यम् एण्ड् विशेषं. वन्स् वि लुक् एट् दि एक्साम्पल्स् इट् विल् बि क्लियर्. याता किं न मिलन्ति सुन्दरि पुनश्चिन्ता त्वया मत्कृते नो कार्या नितरां कृशासि कथयति एवं सभाष्पे मयि. लज्जामन्थरतारकेण निपतत् पीताश्रुणा चक्षुषा दृष्ट्वा मां हसितेन भावि मरणोत्साहस्तया सूचितः. अत्र प्रस्थानात् किम् इति किमिति निवृत्तः. प्रस्थानात् किमिति निवृत्तः असि इति कार्ये पृष्टे कारणम् अभिहितम्. अत्र सो सुन्दरी समन् इस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् ए सिचुवेशन् हियर्. सो वि आर् गोयिङ्ग् टु अस्यूम् और् वि आर् गोयिङ्ग् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् द कारणं लेटर् by akshepa. So the shloka just goes like this. Hey sundari, oh beautiful lady, yataha kim na milanti, those who all leave, don't they meet each other? They definitely meet each other. So tvaya punaha matkrite chinta no karya. Don't worry matkrite, for me you need not worry. So matkrite chinta no karya, don't unnecessarily worry yourself on my behalf, on my account. Krisha asi. See, because you have worried about me, nitaram krisha asi, you have become very thin now. Iti evam mayi kathayati sati. Sa bashpe mayi kathayati sati. As I am saying this with tears in my eyes, sa, she looked at me. So, taya hasitena suchitaha. So drishtva, first she looks at me. How does she look at me? Chakshusha drishtva, with one eye she just looked at me. So with the corner of the eye she just looks at the nayaka who is saying these things. You know, once they go, it is not that we won't meet again. We will definitely meet again. Why are you unnecessarily worrying about me? Because of this worry you have become very thin. Iti, I'm crying and telling her, you know, don't become so thin, you look very So lajjamantara tarakena, as soon as I have said this, she looks at me with one eye, which is lajjamantara tarakena. The taraka is the pupil of the eye, which is mantaram, which is very lethargic or very slowly she is looking at me because she is also very shy. She is feeling very shy. So lajjayaha karanena tarakam mantaram. It is very shanaihi evam lolam na chanchalam nasti mantharam asti mandam mandam chalati nipatat pita ashruna. As the tears are falling, pitam, it is, she is trying very hard to stop her tears from falling. Tadrisha chakshusha, so it means You know very clearly that she is going to cry at any moment, but she's trying to stop that and making a great effort to stop her crying. At the same time, she's also feeling very shy to look at him. Navavadhu. It shows very clearly that she is a Navavadhu. Lajja Karanath. This is from Amarashatakam, the shlokam. So Drishtva, Mam Drishtva, after looking at me, Taya Bhavi Marana Utsahaha. Hasitena suchitaha. She just smiles a little bit at me. No, he is crying and he's saying, don't worry unnecessarily. But she just looks at him with one eye, which is filled with ashru, at tears, and she smiles at him. See, at this point, that smile is completely incongruent. It doesn't gel with the situation. How can she smile? So because of that smile, Bhavi maranam, bhavi bhavishyat kale nischayena virahat virahakaranat mama maranaha eva jayate iti suchitaha marana utsaha. I won't be able to, hold on to my life if you leave me and go. The virahakaranat iti taya suchitaha hasitena, by that smile. So all of this is the karyam. No, sorry. This is the karanam, right? Why did I? Yes, this is the karanam. What is the reason for you? Someone is asking, he has left the Nayaka who prasthanat, who had already prepared to go away on a journey, but he came back. So someone is asking him the reason. The reason is being described here. So the actual varnana is about a person who has left and he is coming back. Why have you come back is the question that is relevant here. But without even mentioning that question, which is relevant, which is the karyam, he is talking about the karanam, why he came back. So the description is about, I wanted to leave. Your question is correct. I wanted to leave, but I have come back. Why have you come back? So I have come back is the Nayaka coming back is your prasthana nivrittihi eva atra karyam. Tat akshiptamasti. Karanam tu atra varnitamasti. Kim karanam? Bhavi maranam. मरणस्य उत्साहः हसितेन सूचितः इति वर्णना एव अत्र कारणम् दट् इस् नाट् द प्रस्तुतम् बिकास् द पर्सन् हू इस् आस्किङ्ग् द कारणम् इस् नाट् नेसेसरि इस् जस्ट् द क्वश्चन् इस् द रेलेवेन्स् आफ् द सिचुवेशन् द रीसनिङ्ग् इस् आक्षिप्तम् ओके होप् दट्स् क्लियर् द नेक्स्ट् वन् विल् बि आपोसिट् वेर् the varnitam would be the karyam and the karanam would be akshipta. Okay, so karane prastute sati. Karanam, the reason is prastutam, whereas the karyam, which is the effect, is the aprastutam, which is varnitam. So in aprastuta prashamsa, every time what is being described will always be aprastutam. That is not context. राजन् राजसुतान् अपाठयति मां देव्योऽपि तूष्णीं स्थिताः कुब्जे भोजय मां कुमार सचिवैः न अद्यापि किं भुज्यते इत्थं नाथ शुकस्तव हरिभवने मुक्तः अध्वगैः पञ्जरात् चित्रस्थान् अवलोक्य शून्य बलभौ एकैकम् आभाषते अत्र प्रस्थान उद्यतं भवन्तं ज्ञात्वा सहसैव त्वदरयः पलाय्य गताः इति कारणे प्रस्तुते इति कारणे प्रस्तुते कार्यम् उक्तम् सो द कॉन्टेक्स्ट हियर इज अ किंग हैज स्टार्टेड ऑन हिज एक्सपेडिशन ही इज गोइंग टू गो एंड अटैक एन एनिमी एंड एज सून एज द न्यूज अराइव्ड एट द एनिमीज प्लेस दैट द किंग हैज लेफ्ट हिज भवनम फॉर अटैक प्रस्थानात् उद्यतम एव अत्र So prasthanam, sorry, prasthana udyatam, prasthanam prati udyatam. One who has just who is getting himself ready to leave for battle. He is only getting ready. He has made a decision to leave. That's all. He has not yet left. So prasthana udyatam bhavantam yatva kavihi rajanam vadati. So bhavantam, you know, hey Rajan, you, the moment they hear that you have made a decision to leave for the battlefield, sahasa eva tvadarayaha palayya gataha, your enemies have all immediately, they have left the their antapuram or their prasada, their palaces, and they have run away from their palaces. So this is the karanam. Because of this, what has happened now, as they were going, they were taking all their belongings on the road. One of the belonging was a parrot in a cage. Now this parrot, it started shouting because of the commotion and everything in on the way, and some of the travelers had let go of that parrot from the cage. Now this parrot, it knew only that place, the palace where it was brought up. So the parrot flies straight to the palace, and it is looking at all the pictures in the palace. There are murals of all the Rajaputra and everybody. Maybe even the attendants are also being painted on the walls, or paintings are there. It is looking at all the paintings, and it is talking, you know, why is nobody teaching me anything? Where are the ladies in this house? Give me some food. And he is continuously, the parrot is talking in the empty house alone, in the empty palace alone. So that is the description that is being given, which is actually the effect of the enemies running away. So now look at the shlokam. Hey Rajan, hey Natha, tava aribhavane, in your enemy's palace, advagaihi panjarat muktaha shukaha. The parrot which was released from the cage by the advagaihi, by the travelers, shunya valabhau chitrasthana avalokya. Shunya valabhau, in the empty, valabhi is a terrace or in a room, in a hall. Shunya valabhi, the empty hall, chitrasthana avalokya, it looks at the painting people, the people who have been painted in the paintings, avalokya, looking at them, the parrot. Ekaikam itham abhashate, it talks to each and every person there. So it says, hey Rajan, it looks at the painting of a king and says, Rajasuta mam na pathayati, the princess is not teaching me at all. Next, he looks at all the ladies who have been drawn there. Devyaha api tushnim sthitaha pashya. See, even these ladies are all keeping quiet and standing there. Hey Kubje, mam bhojaya. Kubje, Kubja is a hunchback person. She's a servant who gives food to the parrot. So the parrot is looking at that Kubja and saying, Kubje, bhojaya mam, give me some food. Hey Kumara, that Kumara Sachivaihi na Adhyapikim Bujyate can be made into two, where you can say Kumara as Sambodhana Pratama, Athava Kumara Sachivaihi iti, you can say young ministers. So hey Kumara, looking at the prince, Yuvaraja, why are you not eating with the Sachivaihi Saha, ministers? Sachivaihi Saha, along with the ministers, Adhyapikim Bujyate. Kim na bujyate, you have to understand. Are you still eating with those? Na adhyapi. Sorry, I didn't look at that. Adhyapi kim na bujyate, are you still not sitting down and eating with those ministers? Why are you like this? So it is looking at the painting, such a sad situation. Imagine one parrot which is looking at all the paintings in an empty palace. Palace itself is so big, and if it's empty, it's even more pathetic, no, to think about that scene. So, iti hittam nata shukaha tava aribhavane mukto advagaihi panjarat chitrasthana avalokya shunya valabho ekaikam avashate. It looks at each and every person and talks. So this is the karyam. What is the, this is the effect. So what is the reason for this? The reason is everybody has emptied and run away from the palace because they heard that you were going to come to the battle. So karye prastute, so karane prastute, karanam prastutam tu akshiptamatra, karyam varnitam tu aprastutam. No, the praising the king should be your context, not describing the parrot. So describing the parrot will become the karanam, which is also aprastutam, and aprastutasya eva atra varnana prashamsa kriyate. The third type is samanya visheshanam. It's a more simpler, simple to understand, where samanyam is anything in general, visheshanam is one particular thing. Samanyam, for example, you can say a class of animals, where visheshanam would be one particular, one cow, or a class of cows, and Nandini or Kamadhenu is one particular. It depends on how you are describing the Samanyam and how it applies to the Vishesha. In this particular, Samanye Prastute Sati, Visheshasya Aprastutasya Varnanam Atra Kriyate. Etattasya Mukhat Kiyat Kamalini Patre Kanam Varinaha Yan Muktamani Rityamstha Sajaraha Shirunvan Yad Asmadapi Angulyagra Laghu Kriya Pravilayini Adiyamaneshanaihi Kutra Uddiyagataha Mama Iti Anudinam Nidrati Nanta Shucha. Very nice way of talking about how a person who is a fool or an intelligent, non-intelligent person will look at things. So jadaha kaschit atra astane jadana mamatva sambhavana bhavati. Astane, astane, where it is not relevant, any person who is a jada, who does not have that intelligence to understand which one is correct and which one is maya or which one is illusion, he will think that it is his. So here one particular person, saha jadaha, he is describing about a visheshaha, and we have to take the shloka as describing the context is about how generally jada, any fool person, any unintelligent person will behave. That is the relevance. I want to talk about how generally people without intelligence will work. Then I'm, you know, there was one person, which means that is the vishesha. I'm describing about the action of one person, which is the vishesham. I don't want to talk about that vishesha, one person who is unknown. I'm not talking about that action, which is not relevant here, but I'm describing the non-relevant one person's action by to indicate or to tell people about the behavior of jadaha in general. So etat tasya mukhat shrutam, tasya mukhat eva shrutam etat kiyat. You have to add a lot of your own words for such shlokas to make it more meaningful. So tasya mukhat etat kiyat, that's all is given in the text as such, so we have to understand the rest. So tasya mukhat shrutam maya etat. Etat kiyat iti pashya. So I got this news from him directly. So one person, he could not sleep very well. Antashucha, he was feeling very upset every day. Anudinam, every day. Shucha, because of sadness, because of grief. Dukkham, antaha na nidrati. Antaha, antapure athava shayana grihe na nidrati. He does not even sleep properly. He is spending sleepless nights. So I went and asked him, tasya mukhat eva etat shrutam maya. He only told me the reason for not sleeping. So what is that? Etat kiyat pashya. See how, look at this incident, what he said. What did he say? Yat saha jadaha kamalini patre sthitam varinaha kanam muktamanihi iti amamstha. He looked at a small droplet of water on the lotus leaf and thought, amamstha, he thought that it was muktamanihi. Kamalini patre, on a lotus leaf, varinaha kanam drishtva. Stitam varinaha kanam. there was a drop of water on the lotus leaf, and what did he think? Muktamanihi iti amamsta iti amanyata. Asmadapi anyata shrunu. Listen to something. Shrunu anyata asmadapi. I will tell you something even more foolish than this. Itopi adhikam jadatvam badami shrunu. Kintate yate shanaihi adiyamane. He was trying to take it very carefully with the angulyagra, anguli agram, the tip of his finger. He was trying to take it shanaihi, with very consciously, very slowly, adiyamane sati. What happened to that drop of water? What does it happen? It just vanishes, right? It just becomes either it makes your hand wet, or it just evaporates, it just falls down. It won't be there in your finger. So anguli agra laghu kriya pravilayini pravilayam ityukte disappear tiraskar tirohitam abhavat laghu kriya by the small action of the front portion of the finger pravilayini it was pravilayini sati when it had disappeared. Now what did he think? He didn't think that it was water. Even now he thought kutra gataha uddiya uddiya kutra gataha mama, where did my that mut muktamanihi, where did that pearl go away, fly and go away? Uddiya gataha iti anudinam shucha antaha nidna nidrati. Anta shucha ne nidrati, that also could be you can take it as one word and say anta shucha, because of the grief that he has inside, he is constantly Tamil, we say ulla marigi marigi. He keeps thinking about it continuously and he does not sleep. He spends a sleepless night. So atra aprastutam tu jada visheshasya ekasyaiva jada purushasya jalakane muktamani dhihi muktamanihi iti yaha jada dhihi asti tasya varnanam atra kritam. Aprastutam tu samanyam jadanam eva evam eva asthane ayogyasthane yatra muktamanitvameva nasti tatra jalakane muktamani riti bhavaha yatha vidyate tatha sarvatrapi jadanam evameva vyavaharaha drishyate. Anywhere where it is not something that they can take it for themselves, or something that is something different, even a shukti rajatam. He may look at an oyster shell and think it is shukti, it is rajatam, and try to scrape it out of an oyster shell. He can think it is a silver and try to take it out. Or even in places where someone is not even respecting him, he could go there and say, think that they are all respecting him and try to behave. Na? The ayogya sthane mamatva sambhavana ityukte, this is mine. They think that even that pearl is theirs and try to grab it for themselves. That is also another way of looking at it. So this is another type of aprastuta prashamsa. The next one is where aprastutam is samanyam. It is the reverse of that, the earlier shlokam, where there is a description of a samanyam and the vishesha is akshiptam. This we can know only if there is a prasangam there, only if there is a context. Shri Krishnena narakasure hate tat suhrudam shalvam prati tan mantrinaha uktihi. This is the prasanga that is given in the vyakhyanam, in the commentary. So the death of Narakasura has happened. Krishna has killed Narakasura. Narakasura's friend is Shalvaha, and Narakasura's mantri is trying to advise Shalva, and he is trying to instigate him to go and kill Krishna. You will have to go and kill him. Suhrid vadhu bashpa atra krishnam nihatya narakasura vadhunam yadi dukkham prashamayasi tat tvam eva shlagyah iti visheshe prakrite. So the context is, you will have to go and kill, take revenge for Narakasura's death, go kill Krishna, and that is how you can remove the dukkham or the ashru pramarjanam kartum shaknoshi. Dukkham that Narakasura Vadhu, the wives of Narakasura are experiencing, you can remove that Dukkham and you will be praiseworthy only if you do that by killing Krishna. So that is the Prastutam, which is Vishesha. Vishesha is Naraka, okay, killing of Krishna and the advice being given to Shalva, which is a particular thing. So in general, what is this? If your friend's wife is crying, it is the responsibility of the person to try his level best to remove that dukkham that is there in his wife's wife, the friend's wife. So Suhrid Vadhu Bashpa Jala Pramarjanam Karoti Vaira Pratiyatanena Yaha Sayeva Pujya Sapuman Sanitiman Sujivitam Tasya Sabhajanam Shriyaha. So a description of a samanyam. Generally, only that person who is capable of taking revenge and removing the dukkham of his friend's wife, only that person would be considered as pujyaha. He is only puman, neetiman, tasya eva jivitam, sujivitam, saha eva shriyaha bhajanam bhavitum arhati. Iti samanyasya varnanam kriyate atra. Kintu prastutam, prakritam tu. What is the context here? It is Krishna hananam. And Narakasura Vadhunam Dukkha Ashruni Pramarjayitavyani Iti Tadeva Prakritamatra. Look at the shlokam here. So Yaha Yakaschite, any person who Vaira Pratiyatanena, by taking a revenge on Vaira, Vaira Virodhitvam, if by taking a revenge on Virodhitvam, or Vaira can also be Shatru. So Shatru Pratiyatanena, by going towards the enemy or attacking the enemy, Suhrit Vadhu Bashpa Jala Pramarjanam Karoti. If he removes the Bashpa Jalam tears of Suhrit Vadhu, his friend's wife, Saeva Pujyaha. He is the Pujayitum Yogyaha Sahayeva. Saeva Puman, he can only be called as a man, Purusha Akara. Puman ityatra Purushaha, not man, but it's more to do with the Utsaha Shakti Yuktaha Saeva Asti ityarthe. Saha Neetiman, he only knows the correct policies because Chanakya Neeti allows that revenge. Tasya Eva Sujivitam, Tasya Jivitam Eva Sushtu Jivitam. Only his life can be praised as a good life. Tasya eva saha eva shriyaha bhajanam bhavati rajya shrihi. So if you take revenge, then you can take this kingdom and rule this kingdom. Only you can be worthy of this kingdom. So atra aprastutam samanyam varnitam asti mitra vadhu bashpa marjanasya eva shlaghyatvam vartate iti samanyam aprastutam. Kintu prastutam atra Krishna Hananath Narakavadhunam Dukkha Shamanena Tvam Shakyaha Shlagyaha Prashasyaha. You will be praiseworthy. Okay. I will stop with this. We will look at the rest next class.